Hey there, Angel Alvaro here, and I'm here at Delta Toronto East. This weekend I was attending the Millionaire Mind Intensive, and I had one of the biggest breakthroughs yesterday, and today I'm going to share it with you, one of the many breakthroughs I have. And this is also part of my day 10 video for our 90-day video challenge. Can you imagine? It's already day 10. Oh my gosh. But I'm so excited to share with you the breakthrough or the big aha moment that I had yesterday. Yesterday, we talked about the three methods or three ways of conditioning. So we have verbal, we have modeling, and a specific incident. Verbal, modeling, and specific incident. And today, I'm going to share with you about the verbal conditioning. So verbal conditioning, it's basically the beliefs that we have about money while growing up. Beliefs that we heard from our parents, could be from teacher, or it could be from anybody in our environment, or it could be from our culture. In this case, my money beliefs that I've been hearing while growing up is the following. Save your money for the rainy days. Don't be a spendthrift. You can only have money when you get a high-paying job, and therefore you have to finish your education. You can only be rich after finishing your education. So therefore, if you don't finish your education, you have no chance of becoming rich. You have to work hard for money. Money goes away fast. It doesn't stay. Money is easy to spend, but it's hard to earn. You can get rich by saving money. So these are some of the money beliefs that I have while growing up. These are the money beliefs that I've been hearing, not just from my parents. It could be from my aunts, my uncles, it could be from my teacher. It could be from anybody in my environment or the culture that I grew up with in the Philippines. So verbal conditioning, what did it do to my life? Maybe in the past it served me, but now it's not really serving me anymore. So I have to let go of them. I have to learn of letting them go because they are not serving me anymore at present. How about you? Can you think of any verbal conditioning that you have from the past? Because by digging this out and bringing it in the open, it might help you to realize what's been holding you back from getting your dreams or achieving the success that you've been wanting. So my challenge for you today is to uncover, try to remember what are the verbal conditioning that you have about money in the past, ever since you're growing up, the earliest memory that you have about money. And tomorrow, I'm going to share with you about the second conditioning, which is modeling. So that's all for today, and hopefully you will try and do this exercise because this is very powerful. After the second and third exercise, you will understand more and better why it's important to do this. So do this, and I'll see you next time for the next video. And let's all grow and uncover all these money beliefs that is not serving us or our purpose at present. Have a great day. Bye now.